Well, I challenge this guy, Oliver Kim, to have some comments. Do you have some comments? Good game?
Yeah.
Right team win?
Mm-hmm.
He really talks a lot, honestly. So excited about the win.
Yeah, but not in front of the camera.
No, we're good. All right. Excited about the win. I do think the University of South Dakota is a very good football team, and I do think they will win some football games this year. Really excited about how our defense played. I'm excited about a lot, but the biggest thing is I love our players. I told them that in the locker room. I can't say anything stronger. They work so hard. They're a picture of student athletes. And I think I learned this on the farm. You deserve success when you do that, and they do that. They do it day in and day out, and I just really proud and love them. So glad to get the win. Want anything to add? You think of stuff, right? So you're not caught off guard, okay? Questions.
John, you know, first time getting these guys here in 4 years, and you get a sellout crowd, beautiful weather and everything. I mean, just how happy were you with the atmosphere that your fans provided and the way your team seemed to respond to it?
Yeah, thanks for the reminder, Matt. I mean, I said it on the radio. That had an impact. It has an impact if you don't make a noise to see the stands full. It has an impact when you give energy, which they did. And it has an impact when you stay when the game's seemingly over, but you stay and enjoy the celebration with the victory. So very honoring, and I appreciate our fans.
You talked about your defense, but not just how well they played, but, you know, USD had a little momentum early. They had a lead, and then they were getting back in deep into your territory. They could have even taken a two-score lead. It seemed like every time they had an opportunity, your defense immediately snuffed that out, and that flipped the momentum and gave your offense a chance to get going.
Yeah, I would say the greatest thing about our defense isn't technique, isn't speed, isn't depth, it is confidence. And they take the field on the nine-yard line going in, the kickoff return, which shouldn't have happened, and block a field goal interception on the first example. They just go out there. They don't hang their head. We play great technique. We play great schemes and all that stuff. But when you play that with guys that are confident and believe in what they're doing, good things happen. And good things happened today.
Did you do anything differently schematically? Bob mentioned a couple different looks on your front. Reese mentioned a couple different techniques on the line.
We change every week. I mean, that's football, and I would say, as we react to that, we have rules, and so if it's different, apply your rules. And we did that in the game against them, where we had to zone something up rather than pull a guy, and so that's the chess game of football. So yes, we did some different stuff. We play a lot of defense, Matt. We play a lot of defense, and that's the other thing. I'm amazed at how well our guys can do with playing all that defense. So,
is it more than you used to this year?
No. We did throw some stuff out, but we still play a lot of defense. Now, I'm thinking about when I was a D coordinator, and you called two defenses, and there were always two backs in the backfield, and we didn't have this, you know, what kind of offense. So. Uh-huh.
Your offensive line pretty much won the game in the third quarter. I mean, you went on a 15-play, 8-minute drive. It was still a football game, and you just controlled the ball for so long that by the time that drive was over, they didn't have enough time to come back. What can you say about your offense on that drive?
Yeah, just, again, good calls by Zach. And it's just not the offensive line. It's the tight ends getting involved. Mike Morgan made a lot of blocks today on counter. Zach Hines made a lot of blocks. One of our big runs, it wasn't then, but in the first half, one of our wide receivers blocked a blitzing corner and allowed us to get outside. So it's a team effort, but the big guys played well today against a very good USD defense.
Coach, you guys had a lot of big plays in the first, or a couple big plays that kind of paced your offense in the first half, and then you had a more consistent effort in the second half. How do you get that more consistent effort compared to kind of where it was in the first, where you guys took a little bit to get going?
You know, when we weren't making big plays during the season, people said, where are the big plays? I'd prefer 4 yards. My college roommates just said we look like Ohio State, 4 yards in a cloud of dust, the old Ohio State. So I just want to win the football game. And so you have to give credit to your opponent. And sometimes you get it all dialed up and a kid makes a great play and it's second and eight rather than you thought it was going to be second and four. I don't ever second guess our coordinators. They work so hard. I thought Zach had an unbelievable plan, he and his staff. So I think when we can go, 15 plays, 8 minutes, I'll take that. That discourages everybody, USD's fans on down to their program. So I'll take that any day.
You keep saying South Dakota is a good football team. Did you expect more from them, after that start where they sort of had a little bit of momentum?
I think we made some big plays. The interception after the muff punt, the blocked field goal, Isaiah Davis's run, however long it was, I think all 11 guys had a chance to tackle him. Momentum, confidence. We didn't have a ton of yards. I mean, they did a nice job, and there were a lot of plays that were 2 yard gains. So, I'm a defensive guy. I'm not trying to say something to make people feel good. They're a good defense. They really are.
After that muff punt, obviously the best possible thing happened for you guys, getting a turnover in the end zone. I mean, was that sort of the play that the game changed?
We tell our guys, I'm not trying to not say yes or no. I would tell our guys to be ready to make a play that makes a difference in the game, and that one made a difference in the game. I mean, from discouraging them to energizing us, surely that was a huge play in the game. Every week I go through and pick out 4 or 5 plays and show it to our booster club and say, in my opinion, these are the plays that were difference maker plays. That play will be on there in answer to your question.
All right, Coach, just with your pass defense tonight, I know you talked about being worried about playing Carson Camp, a running quarterback this week. How do you feel like you were able to contain him there with 7 sacks?
I think a similar thing happened down at Missouri State, where we got on a roll with some fresh guys, and they got close to him, and they sacked him. And quarterbacks don't like to be sacked, right? Mark Gronowski doesn't like to be sacked. And so pretty soon your total focus isn't on your keys, it's on that left defensive end. And then he got his ankle rolled up on too, which I'm sure has an impact too. So we play a lot of guys on the D-line. They're fresh. They go hard. Great. Our guys are great technicians. And so I think that impacted Carson. I did tell him at the end of the game that I thought he was a really good football player, and I believe that, and expect him to go out and make plays.
How did this win feel today compared to last year's loss?
You want to answer that one? here's I had motivation because I went out to the tailgate, and I had 2 people remind me to defend the Hail Mary today, as if I had needed that. But that's okay. I mean, you want people to be excited and passionate about it. Light years difference. That was a crushing victory or loss, and yet I've coached enough that I have to be an example to our players that if that's the worst thing that ever happens in our lives, we're going to have 110, 140 really blessed people, and it cost us a seed. It made the road to Frisco much tougher. All those things, one play, right? But I'm going to enjoy this victory a lot. So.
Did you come out relatively healthy today?
We did. Yeah, we did. It was a physical game, and some guys will be, need rehab tomorrow and need hot yoga tomorrow, but they'll be good.
Well, we talked a little bit about the uniqueness or difficulty of having 2 rivalry games in a row. Do you think the way this game played out, just in the second half and winning it comfortably and having some momentum, that kind of a best possible case scenario going into another rivalry game right after it?
Well, we surely gained confidence from this game. That would be the thing that I think adds to the upcoming game. We respect North Dakota State. We embrace the rivalry. It's one of the greatest, I think, in college football. And it's going to be 1 versus 2 in the nation, I believe, in at least 1 poll. So we take 1 game at a time. So I don't know how this game will impact us, other than we should be confident that we can play good football, and we'll be healthy. And ideally, we get a couple more guys back, which I think adds to our ability to play Jackrabbit football.
Just 1 more from me.
I have no friends, so keep going.
No worries. With an emphatic of a win this year at home, taking away something. I don't want to say it took away any of the sting from last year, but are you more open to possibly having a chance to go win at the Dakota Dome in the future? I know after what you said last year about not wanting to go back there after the game.
I shouldn't have said that because it backs me into a corner, and so to speak. I love what I do. I love what I do. And so if we're going to the Dakota Dome, the Fargo Dome, the Uni Dome, Frisco, Texas, I love what I do. And I've been blessed doing it. So I will embrace going back to the Dakota Dome. I will. And I think they did a great job with the facility and had a great visit with their athletic director today. I respect him. And, yeah, I don't mind going back there at all.